I recently got this question that says, hi Barb, is there a way or formula that a self-generating reference number is created each time I open a document? I'm in logistics and we're sending multiple shipments every day and I'm always manually creating these reference numbers. With the use of a little goods out of the book, we would appreciate your help with this. So what I did is, I don't know what they're doing, but I assume it's a sales type thing. So I've got a basic form here and it's got the sales order number as 4. And then you would put in the customer and let's say Smith's company. And description as some stuff. Okay, so now let me show you the code. I also have a save button on here, so we'll look at both code. So what I've done is I've right-clicked on the sheet tab, to view code, and then you go into the view code here, and then what I've done is I've selected the workbook. So when the workbook is open, then you're going to workbook, and it's when it's on, it's on. Open is the other thing that you're selecting here. So when the workbook is open, then the range worksheet sheet 1 range C4, you just add 1 to it. Now when this is open, you want to clear the fields that contain contents. So you clear the contents of F4, which is the customer name. And then you clear the contents of F6, which is the description. Okay, so now a button to close this. So let me show you this. So basically I have a command button, and I've declared two things. I've declared a path and a string name. And so what I'm doing is I'm actively saving the workbook, because we need that the original workbook to be saved so that the number increments for the next one. The path I have used the path. I have a demo on my desktop. So what I've done is I've gone to my folder, and I have simply clicked on here, copied this, and brought it back. And don't forget to put the quotation marks on the beginning, the backslash at the end, and then ending quotation marks. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to name this file as sales order, and then whatever number it is displayed in the, so it's going to be sales order and then 4, just taking the display alerts false equals false, so we don't get to see the error that, are you sure you want to save this? And then active workbook save as file path name, which we've done up here, file name, which we did here, and file format is XL, so it's just an ordinary workbook. Application display alerts equals true, active workbook close. So let's go run this and see what it does. So I've got Smith Company, some stuff, and then I'm going to click on the run button. So right now we're on 4, so we're going to click on save. So it's going to close everything. And then if I go to my file folder where it's saving, I have sales order 4. And now if I open up my sales order again, so basically I have sales order 5, the customer name is cleared now, the description is cleared now, and so this is how you get the number increment every time you open the file, and this is how you clear the fields for the customer name and description and whatever else you would have in here. So I will include this code in my description of the video. Please subscribe.